ladies and gentlemen, Miss Shirley Bassey.
A song for you, the very song for you. I've got a song that says you are my happiness and I'm in love with you. Every love word is revealing feeling in my heart. Every note I sing will linger, even when we're far apart. You're gonna hear from me happy melody with such a catchy sound. It's bound to stay around and never let you free. It wants to show you how I love you. It wants to tell you I'll be true. So how can we go wrong if you will swing along and let me sing my song for you? You're gonna hear from me chances we'd be sharing love before the night was through. Something in your eyes was so inviting. Something in your smile was so exciting. Something in my heart told me I must have you. Strangers in the night, two lonely people, we were strangers in the night, up to the moment when we said our first hello. Little did we know that love a warm embracing dance away. Ever since that night, we've been together, lovers at first sight, in love forever.
Good evening to you, ladies and gentlemen. Some time back, I made a long-playing album with Mr. Nelson Riddle. And one of the songs from this album was issued as a single in Europe, and I'm very happy to say became a very big hit for us both. I would like to sing that song for you right now. What now, my love? Now that you've left me, how can I live through another day? Watching my dreams turn into ashes, and my hope into bits of flame. Once I could see, once I could see, now I am numb, I've become. You've heard Bassey. Now it's time for Basie. It is my pleasure and privilege to introduce the great Count Basie and his orchestra.
Thank you. hit you up in the joint. I could see you were a man of distinction, a real big spender. Good looking, so refined. Say, wouldn't you like to know what's going on in my mind? So let me get right to the point. I don't pop my cock for every man I see. Hey, big spender, spend a little time with me. Wouldn't you like to have fun, fun, fun? How's about a few laughs, laughs? I could show you a good time. Let me show you a good time. The minute you walked in the joint, I could see you were a man of distinction, a real big spender. Good looking, so refined. I say, wouldn't you like to know what's going on in my mind? So let me get right to the point. I don't pop my cork for every man I see. Hey, big spender.
I should like to sing a song written by Mr. Irving Berlin. It is a very sad but beautiful love song. I don't want him. You can have him. He's not worth fighting for. Besides, plenty more where he came from. I don't want him. You can have him. I'm giving him the sack so he can go right back where he came from. I'm afraid I never loved him. He'd be better off with you. I could never make him happy. His clothes and down his socks, fetch his slippers and remove his shoes, wipe his glasses when he read the news, rub his forehead with a gel. Mornings after, when he had a little too much, kiss him gently when he cuddled me, and give him babies, one for every year. So you see,
that you can't have him. I don't want him. I don't want him. You can have him. Because he's not the man for me. Then I'd close the windows while he soundly slept. Then I'd raid the icebox where the food is kept. I'd fix him breakfast that would please him most. Eggs and coffee and some butter toast. You can have him, you can have him. I don't want him, I don't want him. You can have him. Because he's not the man for me.
Kiss of death from Mr. Goldfinger.
I first arrived in America from England, I made a startling discovery. I noticed that the Americans and the British have very much in common. For one thing, they have a native language that is somewhat similar. I'm sure there are times when an American believes that he can actually understand every word an Englishman says. My next song is typically English. Oh, by the way, I myself am not English. I am Welsh, from Welsh Wales. My mother said I never should play with the young men in the wood. If I did, she would say, "You naughty little girl to disobey." I'm a typically English rosebud, born of typically English stock, with a typically Anglo-Saxon family tree. I received my education in a typically English way at a typically English girl academy. I play typically English tennis at a typically English club with a typically English feeling for fair play. I eat typically English crumpets with my typically English tea at the end of every typically English day. Father is a typically English colonel. Home is a typically English country town. Mummy and I play typically English patience while the typically English rain is pouring down. We've a typically English spaniel who likes typically English walks past a typically English tree upon the heath. And if anyone asks me how I like this typically English life, well, I'm fed up to my typically English tea. My mother said I never should play with the young men in the wood. If I did, she would say, "You'll only end up in the family way." A typically English suitor in a typically English suit calls to take me out to typically English tea. There's a typically English table booked for typically English two, but my typically English mother makes it three. When we go to typically English dance, says la da, la da, la da. Mother gives me typically sound advice, how to cope with typically coarse advances, but I'm bound to confess I find them rather nice. Stay there. In the typically English summer, we take typically English halls at a typically English place with Auntie Maud. And if anyone asks me how I like this typically English life, I have never been so bloody bored.
My nose pressed up against the window pane.
must watch you go dancing by, wrapped in the arms of somebody else. But darling, 'tis I who
Mr. Count Basie.
Climb every mountain.
till you find your dream. A dream that will need all the love you can give. Every day of your life, for as long. Thank you. About 10 years ago, when I was 12, would you believe 13? I made my debut in a very classy joint in London, England, Europe, in a place called the Café de Paris. And it was terribly posh, really. And I sang a not too posh song at the time, which can only now be referred to as Early Shirley. And so with the help of a new arrangement, we've sort of poshed it up a little. And it sounds something like this. Now when it comes to a question of sin, as my young man would say, well, it all depends on what you mean by sin today. You can be born in it, live in it, and die in it. And you can pay for it, given it, and lie for it. You can see the devil in it. As for me, I revel in it. Who's got a match worth striking? Don't say it all depends. To help me burn my candle at both ends. Who's got a light he's hiding under a bushel, friends? Who wants to help me burn my candle at both ends? It's possible it may not last the night, and while it burns, what a wonderful light. Who'd like to play with fire as Satan recommends? Who wants to help me burn my candle at both ends? Who doesn't mind the reaper after he's sown wild oats? Who wants to take a chance and help me burn my boats? Who's not a loping leaper? Don't heed a warning note. Who wants to take a chance and help me burn my boats? It may not last, but it's all in the game, my friend. And while it burns, what a fabulous play. Get in deeper, not caring if he floats. Who wants to take a chance and help me burn my boats? And that's for scotch that so directs, and for straight and simple sex. I for invitation to close relationship with you, and for nothing bad no less. Yes, I am, that's it, I guess. Who's got a good ignition waiting for dividends? To help me burn my candle at both ends? Who's in the air condition, won't mind how much he spends? Who wants to help me burn my candle at both ends? It's possible the pace may prove too hot, but then again, it could happen as not. Who has an inhibition weaker than he pretends? Who has an urge to turn the handle? Open my door and spurn the scandal. Who wants to help me burn my candle? Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I must say, recording the theme song for Goldfinger was quite an experience. And after that, I recorded another title song for a film. But this time it was slightly different. It was a quiet, gentle lullaby.
The Jekyll and the Romeo, you know, the devil in disguise. There's no telling where a girl would go, you know, to gaze into his eyes. With the snapping of the fingertips of him, he'll take your wife away. And a whisper from the smiling lips of him, he'll take your wife away. Soon be getting to you. You'll wake up late somewhere up in the blow. The undertaker would never try to deny that the liquidator is a hell of a guy. It wouldn't be in summer, seeing you in summer. I never will go. Your hair streaked with sunlight, your lips red as flame. That puts gold to shame. But if I'd ever leave you, it wouldn't be in autumn. How I'd leave in autumn, I never. And could I leave you running merrily through the snow? Or on a wintry evening when you catch the fire's glow? If ever I would leave you, it wouldn't be in springtime, knowing how. By your soul, alone and in springtime.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. If you have enjoyed this hour as much as we have, then we're terribly happy. I also want to say a very special thank you to Mr. Count Basie.
Thank you, Shirley. And thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And ladies and gentlemen, it's been a ball. And on behalf of Celanese, we'd like to say good night.
Good night.
Arrangements and promotional consideration by Pan American World Airways, world's most experienced.